The leaking oil well in the Gulf of Mexico.
Species extinction.
Global warming.
Researchers predict that temperatures will increase.
They can see the ice is changing.
Our responsibility to our children and our grandchildren.
Energy and the environment will really be one of the fundamental challenges that society faces over the next 50 years.
We need energy that doesn't have greenhouse gas impacts.
You're going to have a sustained push to get these renewables to replace conventional fossil fuels.
There are ways to make biofuels that have benefits and ways that don't.
Everybody miscalculated the impacts of investment in agrofuels, including the environmentalists.
As this new and additional biofuel demand takes hold on agricultural markets, independent observers just about all agree that this will drive food prices up.
Of all the land being bought in Africa, a third of it is for biofuel. 5 million hectares have already been acquired or requested just by EU companies in developing countries alone.
Mostly they're doing what they're allowed to do and often what is legal. But the power balance is such that communities aren't able to question, aren't able to challenge.
What we can't support and what doesn't bring any development is agrofuels being grown on an industrial scale to benefit Europe and for our purposes.
Biofuel policies, biofuels and rising food prices could push hundreds of millions of more people into hunger within the next decade.
Talking about hundreds of millions of people going hungry because of biofuels if all the global targets are met by 2020.
It's the demand and the urgency of the demand that has created a lot of the problems. A lot of investment going in very quickly without thinking through the consequences.
Most of the nations which are rich are in the temperate parts of the world. The temperate parts of the world, which are largely responsible for the problem, are the ones which are going to get hit last and least by climate change.